Hi everyone! In today's tutorial, I'll show you how to choose the best file format for your external drives or storage devices. We will explore the differences between APFS, APFS Encrypted, macOS Extended Journal, MS-DOSFAT, and ExFAT. With this knowledge, you will confidently choose the right file system when using the Disk Utility app on your Mac to format your solid-state drive, USB flash drive, or hard disk drive. Let's get started. To format your external drive or storage device, begin by connecting it to your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, or iMac. For instance, I have a Samsung T7 SSD and will connect it to my MacBook Pro M1. However, sometimes the drive icon may not appear on the desktop immediately. If you encounter this issue, click anywhere on the desktop to access the Finder menu. From the Finder menu, select Settings. On macOS Ventura or Sonoma, click the General tab. Check the box next to External Disks. This will make the SSD icon visible on your desktop, as you can see in my case. In the following step, open the Spotlight by clicking the magnifying icon in the menu bar. Then type Disk Utility in the search box and press Enter on your keyboard to launch it. Now in Disk Utility, click the View icon and make sure Show All Devices is selected. Next, navigate to the left sidebar and click on the icon representing your external drive. This is my external drive, and this one is the internal one. Ensure you select the correct one for formatting. Therefore, I select the Samsung external SSD. Before clicking the erase button, it's crucial to ensure that you have backed up all your files. This step is essential in case something goes wrong during the erasing process, as erasing will completely wipe everything. I will copy this folder to my desktop. Next, ensure that you have selected the top icon of your external disk, then click the erase button and enter a name for your external disk, such as backup or any other preferred name. It's now time to choose the best format based on your needs. APFS, short for Apple File System, is the first format in this pop-up menu. Apple introduced APFS in 2017 as a replacement for the older HFS Plus file system, offering several improvements. APFS is the default file system used by macOS High Sierra and later versions. It's designed to work well with solid-state drives and flash storage devices. If you use a modern Mac with flash or SSD storage and your operating system is macOS High Sierra or later, you are likely already utilizing APFS as the default file system. Whether setting up a new device or formatting an external drive connected to your Mac, it is recommended to choose APFS as the file system for optimal performance, efficiency, and compatibility. The second option in the list is APFS Encrypted. This format is ideal for individuals who want to protect sensitive data, such as financial records, health data, or personal photos. To use this format, you must enter a password or passphrase. If your device goes missing or gets stolen, your data remains secure as it needs a password to access it. The next one is APFS case sensitive. I briefly explained the difference between case sensitive and case insensitive. In a case sensitive file system, a file or folder name presentation in uppercase letters and presentation in lowercase letters would be considered different, allowing the two files to coexist in the same folder. On macOS, the default file system is typically case insensitive. This means that macOS treats uppercase and lowercase letters in file and folder names as identical. For example, suppose you have a file name presentation in uppercase letters and presentation in lowercase letters in the same folder. In that case, macOS considers them the same file and prompts you to resolve the naming conflict, which means you have to change one of your file's name.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe for more. Thank you.
For most users, APFS, APFS Encrypted, or macOS Extended Journal are the best options. There is usually no need to select a case-sensitive option. macOS Extended Journaled is a journaling file system, also known as HFS Plus Journaled or HFS Extended. If you are using macOS 10.12 Sierra or an earlier version, or if compatibility with Time Machine backups is necessary, macOS Extended Journaled is the recommended option. This file system is particularly suitable for older systems with traditional hard disk drives. Another variant of macOS Extended Journaled is the macOS Extended Case Sensitive Journaled file system, designed to be case sensitive to file and folder names. However, if you are using a newer macOS version and have SSD or flash-based storage, it is recommended that you use the APFS file system instead. ExFAT or ExFAT is an abbreviation for Extended File Allocation Table. Unlike FAT32 or FAT32, which has a file size limit of 4 GB, ExFAT supports individual files larger than 4 GB. This makes it a great option for storing high definition videos, large disk images, and other large files. Therefore, if you plan to use an external drive across both Mac and Windows systems, ExFAT is the preferred option due to its compatibility and file size capabilities. The MS-DOS FAT file system format, also known as FAT32, is often used for compatibility with Windows operating systems. If you often exchange files between macOS and Windows systems, formatting a disk with FAT32 ensures that both operating systems can read and write to it without the need for additional software or drivers. However, it's important to note that the maximum file size for MS-DOS FAT is 4 GB. If you need to store a larger file, it's recommended to use ExFAT. Let's now take a closer look at the various partitioning schemes available. GUID partition map is a modern and versatile partitioning scheme. It allows for large drive sizes, supports multiple partitions, and is required for booting macOS on Intel and Apple Silicon Macs. Choose this option for all Intel-based and Apple Silicon Mac computers. Master Boot Record is an older partitioning scheme. It is commonly used by Windows system. However, it has limitations such as supporting only up to 4 primary partitions. If you need to share a drive between macOS and Windows, Master Boot Record might be necessary. Choose this option for compatibility with all Microsoft Windows-based computers. Apple Partition Map was used in older Macs PowerPC architecture. It's rarely needed today unless you are dealing with very old hardware. If you are not using a vintage Mac, it's advisable to stick with the modern and versatile GUID partition map. Let's say you have a 2 or 3 year old MacBook Pro M1, MacBook Air M1, or an iMac with macOS Sonoma, Ventura, or Monterey as the OS. Your Mac's internal disk is SSD, and you have an external SSD that you want to format so that you can use it to backup your files or clone your disk. To format it, you simply choose APFS as the preferred format and select GUID partition map for the scheme. If you made a mistake, there is nothing to worry about. As long as you have backed up your files, you can always format your disk again. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.